Hello friends, hope you are doing well. Myself Haradhan, currently working for a major IT giant as a software test engineer since last 13 years. I am living in Kolkata currently with my beautiful wife and little princess. Nowadays, in testing practice, automation is like mandatory. Most of the clients are preferring automation for cost-saving purpose. So I thought to create complete videos on automation using Selenium. I will definitely create several videos for Selenium, Java, different automation framework like testNG, page object model, Maven, starting from scratch in coming days. In current competitive days, if you want to choose career as automation tester, you have to really work hard to learn an automation tool and a relevant programming language. In case you want to choose a new project or you are thinking for a switch, then you have to go through an interview process where the interviewer will definitely judge your automation and programming skill. So I thought to create few videos for interview question of Selenium and Java. In this video, I will try to give you few important question and answer for Selenium. I will try to cover all sort of questions, means from basic to advanced. If you go through all my videos, I am pretty much sure that you can crack any interview, automation interview. In case you are liking my videos, please like, share, comments, and definitely subscribe my channel so that you will get notification as and when I will upload some new videos. So let's start with Selenium interview question part 1. So in the part 1, I have jotted down 25 questions from Selenium and automations. So first question is like, what is automation testing? Automation testing is a software testing method or technique to test any application and compare the actual outcome with expected outcome. This can be achieved by designing new test script using any relevant automation testing tool. Nowadays, automation is vastly used to automate repetitive tasks and other testing tasks which are difficult to perform manually. Next question is, why do we prefer automation testing instead of manual testing? In manual testing, test cases are used to execute manually without any proper support from any relevant tools. However, for automation testing, test cases are executed with the assistance of one or more appropriate automation tool. Automation testing is also more reliable as there is less chances of human error. In manual testing, in case we have to run the test cases multiple times, every time we need to run it manually, so huge effort we need to spend. However, in automation testing, once we develop the test script, so the script are ready, then we can go ahead and run the test script multiple times with different data permutation combination, and so less time will be required. Then what are the different tools available in the market for automation testing? There are a lot of variety of free and licensed automation tools available in the market currently. So few of them I have listed down below. First is Selenium. It is a very useful tool for automation testing, especially for web application. It provides multiple browser support. QTP or EFT, Quick Test Professional or Unified Functional Testing. It is very useful tool for non-obvious application, and it has already built-in feature for object repository, but it is a licensed tool, not a free tool. RFT also support functional regression, GUI, and data-driven testing. Tosca is very powerful automation tool for functional regression testing of various software product. Silk is also automation testing tool for functional regression testing, especially for desktop, mobile, and web application. Sequentially is also an open source tool for GUI testing. SoapUI is also an automation tool for specific to API testing. APM is an automation tool which supports mobile testing, native app testing, and mobile web application testing. testNG, though it is not an automation tool, but it is an automated automation framework for Selenium, Appium, REST SEO. JUnits, just like testNG, JUnit also an automation framework which is used mostly used by the developer for unit testing. What are the different components available in the Selenium? In the diagram, you can see right four components: Selenium ID, Selenium RC, WebDriver, and Selenium Grid. So till Selenium 1 version 1, Selenium RC was there. From the version 2 onward, Selenium RC and WebDriver was integrated. Current version is Selenium 3. What is Selenium ID? Is a Firefox add-on by which we can create relatively simple test cases and test suites. It has recording and playback mechanism inbuilt, but nowadays we are not much using Selenium ID. Selenium RC or remote control is also known as Selenium 1, which is the first tool where programmer can use their any programming language for creating complex test cases. WebDriver is very useful for in Selenium, which directly communicate to the browsers, thereby controlling the OS level. Selenium Grid is also useful tool which is used with Selenium RC to execute parallel testing like for different browser and from different OS combination. What is the main advantage of Selenium? Why we are using the Selenium tool? First is Selenium is an open source tool, so no license cost is required for this usage. Selenium can be done in any of the most of the programming language like Java, C#, Ruby, Perl, PHP, and Python. Selenium can be used in many OS platform like MS Windows, Mac, and Linux. It supports most of the popular browsers like Chrome, Firefox, Opera, Safari, and Internet Explorer. Selenium Grids help in parallel and distributed testing. Just like I say, using Selenium, we can test in different OS and different browser in the same time. It uses less hardware resources. Then what are the drawbacks we have in Selenium? Selenium does not provide desktop application automation support. Selenium also does not support web service. Selenium driver requires programming language. So unless tester has adequate programming language, using Selenium cannot be done by him or her. No vendor support is there for Selenium because it is a free tool, unlike UFT, that is the license tool, so support is there from HP. As there is no object repository concept in Selenium, maintainability of object becomes very difficult. Then, for performing common tasks required in automation like logging, reading, writing files, reporting, we have to rely on external libraries and other external framework. What is the main advantage of Selenium WebDriver? The first is it is much faster than other Selenium suites like ID or RC. It controls browser by programming language. It supports data-driven testing and cross-browser testing. We can take the data from Excel or CSV file and cross-browser, like we can run the same test case in multiple browser. Then it supports parallel test execution with the help of either JUnit and testNG. If we implement testNG framework in the Selenium WebDriver, we can run from different OS and different browser at the same time, run the test cases. What is the main difference between Selenium and UFT? Selenium is an open source tool, whereas UFT is not an open source license tool. We need to buy the license from HP. Selenium supports different OS environment like MS Windows, Mac, and Linux, but UFT supports only MS Windows. Selenium supports different language like C#, Java, Perl, Python, whereas EFT supports only Vim script. In Selenium, no inbuilt object repository is there, but for EFT, local and shared object repository is available. In Selenium, no built-in reporting feature is available, so we have to rely on testNG and other framework, but in EFT, built-in reporting feature is already there. Selenium supports only web-based application, whereas EFT supports both desktop and web-based application. Selenium uses less hardware resources, whereas EFT uses more hardware resources, means like more RAM is required in case you want to install EFT. For Selenium, it is difficult to set up the environment and use, but for EFT, it is very much easy to set up and use. In Selenium, parameterization can be done via programming, but it is difficult to implement. But for EFT, parameterization already inbuilt, so parameterization is very much easy. In Selenium, it is a free tool, so no reliable support is available from any specific group. But for EFT, it is developed by HP, and we are buying the license, so permanent support is there from HP. Then what are the different type of testing are supported by Selenium? Generally, using Selenium, we used to do functional testing, regression testing, and definitely sanity testing. What are the automation lifecycle we have using Selenium? The first thing we need to do the test planning for automation, where we will first analyze the requirement, analyze the applications in terms of object identification, then we will identify the test case for automation from for functional testing or sanity testing or regression testing. The next is like test script design. Whenever we are talking about test script design, first we need to create the page library, then we will create the reusable methods, then we will design the test draft using different element locator. The next lifecycle is test script enhancement, where we will insert verification point using assert or verify commands. In case any data-driven testing is required, so we'll go with parameterization instead of hard code value. We need to handle expected and unexpected error. Then the next life cycle is like we need to run and debug the test script, where first we will try to locate and isolate error by going through step-by-step execution. Then in case of any wrong output or result is there, we need to debug them. The final and last step of Selenium lifecycle is like we need to analyze test result and we need to report defect. So for that, we need to publish the test result, where we will identify that pass and test failed test cases. And for the failed test cases, we will try to identify the defect. And in case any defect is available, we will try to log them in any of the defect management tool like ALM, Jira, Rally, etc. What are the prerequisites to start with Selenium first? First thing is that in your system, Java should be installed. So URL is already there. In case you are not having Java in your system, you can install from that URL. Then there are Eclipse IDE, so package, like you need to install the Eclipse. Then Selenium WebDriver, so from that URL, you can import the Selenium WebDriver. So Selenium WebDriver is nothing but, a jar file where like inbuilt class are already available and we can use them, so there is no need to create the new classes. Then different driver for different browser, right? In case you want to do Selenium with Chrome browser, so you need to install the Chrome driver. In case you want to do with Firefox driver, so you need to install the Jayco driver. In case you need to automate using iBrowser, so you need to download iDriver. But before downloading, just first you need to verify the different browser version, and based on the browser version, you need to download the compatible driver for that particular browser. How we can set up Eclipse in your systems, maybe laptop or desktop? The first is you can download the Eclipse and then you need to install it. Once installed, so you need to click on the launch, eclipse.exe file. You need to launch it. Once it is launched, then you need to set your workspace to any location, C drive, D drive, wherever you want. After our workspace is set up, you need to create a new project, Java project. But like there are a lot of options is there, you can create Maven project and other also available. Once project is created, I mean using suitable name, then you will see some SRC folders under which you need to create some package. Then within the package, you need to create some class. So your Eclipse is ready. Then how we can import the Selenium jar files to a project? So you need to right click on the project, not the class or package. You need to right click on the project. Once you right click, then like properties for project name, that dialog box will appear. Then you need to click on the Java build path options. Once you click it, then you need to navigate to the library tabs. In the tab, you will find some button called add external jars. You need to click that button. Then whatever Selenium jar file you have downloaded, you need to add them to that particular project. So all the library classes, whatever available in the Selenium jar file, will be associated to that project. What are the different type of web element available in the web page? It is web edit box, like where you can like add some values. Text box, it can be read only, read only elements. Checkbox, drop down box means like kind of list box. Suppose in a particular web page, like country drop down is there, right? So list of country will be available. Combo box, it can be button, it can be radio button, it can be link or hyperlink, it can be image, it can be web table, it can be frame or inner frame. Then what is locator? Locator can be termed as an address that identifies a web element uniquely within the web page. Locator are the HTML properties of a web element. What are the element locators are available for browsers? There are 8 different element locators available for Selenium: ID, name, class name. Then the tag name, like input tag, div tag, select tag. The link text, whenever we have specific link, we will go ahead with the link text. Partial link text, whenever link is huge, so we will go ahead with the partial link text. Then in case we are not able to find any proper attribute, then we will go ahead to the CSS selector or XPath. So whenever you want to create some locators for Selenium, that particular command you need to use: driver dot find element by dot element locator or attribute, then locator value. So driver, what does it mean by driver? Driver is the object or instance of web driver. Find element is the web driver method already inbuilt. By is the predefined class in Selenium. ID is like element locator or attribute, and ID name, we need to enter the value, ID value. How to inspect elements in any web page? How you can create your own XPath or CSS? So for that, you need to inspect the element. In case also you want to find the ID or name or class or tag name. So first you need to open any web page using Internet Explorer or Chrome browsers. Then you need to hit the F12 button from your keyboard. Then there will be inspector icon, so you need to click on that. Then you need to move that icon, move your mouse around the page. Suppose whatever element you want to, attribute you want to find out, then you need to place that cursor within the element. Then, all the annotation will be displayed for that element, and you can create your own XPath, or you can identify ID, name or class name or tag. What is object repository? Object repository is a unique entity which allows a tester to store all objects that will be used in test script in one or more centralized location rather than scattered all over the script, so that other testers can use as and when required instead of creating a new one. Why we use XPath? Actually, we generally use XPath when for a elements does not contain any ID, class or name, so it will be not be easy, right? if we are not finding any ID class or name and it is not unique, so we have to create our own XPath or CSS, then we can identify the object. What are the common expression is associated with XPath? So we can create our customized XPath. So for that you need to gain experience, but like a few basics expression I have jotted down, so you can go ahead with that. First is basic XPath. In case any class name, ID, name is already available, so we can create the XPath easily using those attribute. The contents. In case attribute is changing dynamically, then we will create XPath using the contents method. Using OR and. In case for a particular element, one attribute is not unique. In case we are using two attributes, then it's unique, so we need to use AND. And sometimes we need to use OR in case out of two attributes, two is unique, but one can change anytime, so we'll go ahead with OR. Start with. It is used to identify an element when we are familiar with the attribute value of an element. Then text, in case suppose we want to verify particular message or text, text, then we will just create our XPath using that particular text only. Following, by using following we could select everything on the web page after closing the tag of the current node. Ancestors, using ancestor we can create the XPath for parent, grandparent, etc. Child, so using child we can select all the children element for the current node. Preceding, just like ancestor, we can select all the nodes from the current node, but not the ancestor attribute nodes and the namespace node. Following siblings, using following siblings, we can select all the following siblings of the current node. Sibling means the same levels, right? Of the current node. Parent, so using parent, like we can select the parent of the current node. Position, select the element out of all element present depending on the position number provided. What are the basic XPath symbol available in Selenium WebDriver? So I have listed down all the possible symbols. Generally we use that first symbol, double slash tag name attribute name equal to value. Suppose the tag name, suppose for a whenever you are logging any application in the login page, right, you can see user ID, password, and sign in button, right? Suppose for user ID, the tag name will be input because it is input box. And for the user ID, there can be some name and name, suppose is user ID. So at the rate name and the user ID will be value 1. So that way you can create your XPath. And for the other like contents, I have AND and OR operations like start with, text, followings, ancestor, child, preceding, following sibling, parent. I have already jotted down everything, so you can have a look and you can create your own XPath. What is relative and absolute XPath? Relative XPath is like more likely starting simply by reference element, okay, and then from the reference element you need to navigate to a particular location. It begins with double slash. So example is like already depicted here. An absolute XPath is complete path from the root element to the desired element, and it begins with single slash. We do not have a faith on the absolute XPath because any point of time absolute XPath can change. So instead of absolute XPath, all the time we should go ahead to the relative XPath. Because the reference element position can change, but we can go ahead and it will never fail. But for absolute XPath, in case it is not able to find the root element, so it will fail. Then just like XPath, we can create our own CSS selector also. So I have depicted how to create the CSS selector. So unlike XPath CSS selector, we need to go ahead to the HTML tag, then hash, then value of the ID attribute. So CSS, you can see, right, CSS is pretty much easier than XPath creation, but we should go ahead with XPath only, but we should not much rely on the CSS. So I mean, in example, it is there. Suppose I mean any input type is for any input field, right? If type is submit, so example is like input, then third bucket type equal to submit. So you can create the CSS. Similar like XPath, you can go ahead to start with, end with contents, and also multiple symbols. In case it is multiple symbols is there, so you can go ahead to the multiple symbols also. How we can use submit a form using Selenium? So whenever any kind of button or link is there, right, we can click on that operation. But in case submit, right, we can use the submit method. Suppose for a particular, form, right, after some, filling out all the mandatory field, we can click on the submit. Just example is there, like element.submit. So we can, it will work. What is the difference between find elements and find element? So find element, whenever we want to find a particular element, we will go ahead with the find element. So it finds the first element within the current web page using the grievance locating mechanism. In case multiples object is found, but it will return only single element, first element only. Okay. So in case no element is found, so it will throw some exception, no element, no such element is found. So that is the syntax already provided. Right, whenever we need to go ahead to the find element, diver.findElement by dot locator attribute and locator value. For find elements, we can find all the elements matching with the criteria. So it returns list of object. In case no object is found, it will return empty list. So for that find element syntax is already there, so we need to use the list interface for storing all the value. So thank you all for watching my videos. In case you are enjoying my videos, please like, share, and definitely subscribe my channel. Please post your comments or queries. Stay tuned for my next video. Thank you.